Hey y'all, I am so incredibly excited to begin this declutter series. My makeup declutter at the end of the year is one of the things I look forward to most. I love just starting the new year fresh. So, this is the first video in the series. I've got to take care of some housekeeping things. Believe me, I know you just want to get to the decluttering. I do too. I promise I'll be quick. So first thing, cruelty-free status. About 2 years ago, I decided to go cruelty-free, meaning I didn't purchase any more non-cruelty-free products. However, I decided to use up what I did have, what I already spent my money on. So over the last couple of years, I've been using them up, but it takes a long time to use up makeup. I think a lot of people don't realize that. So I decided by the end of this year, I just want them gone. There's only a couple left. I'm tired of looking at them. Let someone else get some use out of it. Little asterisk to that point is I only had a couple things left until NARS went non-cruelty free halfway through the year this year. So I was faced with the decision of what to do with all these NARS products. I tried to use up what I could. I couldn't finish them all. I'm deciding to get rid of them. Frankly, now if you don't want to, totally cool. You can use them up. The thing is, for me, one, I'm a YouTuber. I can't talk about them. I don't want to talk about them in videos. And honestly, I'm just pissed off every time that I look at them because I feel kind of betrayed. And I know it's nothing personal. All they care about is the money, of course. But yeah, it just kind of pisses me off every time I look at them. So I might as well let someone else get some use out of them. So I am going to get rid of them. There is one, we'll get to it. Second thing is that I have a small makeup collection. I like it that way and I want to keep it that way and I want to continue to shrink it more and more. So if you're coming here thinking you're going to see someone get rid of hundreds of makeup items, it's not even physically possible for me because I don't even own 100 makeup items. I think I own like 80. So just keep that in mind as we're going through this. And the last point that I wanted to make is that I do already have this declutter basket going. I've been decluttering things over the last couple of months, but then it got so close to this declutter that I decided to just hold on to it. That way I could hand out stuff to people all at once. All right, y'all, so let's get into it. I wanted to start with foundations, frankly, because I wanted to start on a high note. I love reviewing foundations, that's why I have way too many, but I found foundations that I absolutely love, and so the vast majority of these are gonna go. Let's start with the Urban Decay All Nighter Foundation. I have the shade 3.5. So when this foundation initially launched, I was super excited for it, for one, but I bought it, I hated it, and I returned it. This one was sent PR, I don't know, 3, 4 months ago. I tried it again, and I don't mind it as much. My problem is the oxidation. A lot of people have the same problem. It goes orange on my skin. I don't hate the formula, but if they could fix that oxidation problem, it might be something I would actually like, but I don't use it because I can't have a foundation turn orange on me. So it is going in the declutter pile. Next, we have the classic Kat Von D Lock It Foundation. I have the shade Light 46 Cool. It is a perfect shade match for me in the winter when I'm at my lightest. I did really like it when I first got it, but I have since found foundations that have amazing coverage and don't feel half as heavy on the skin. Also feel like it kind of clogs my pores and breaks me out. I don't love it anymore and I'm gonna pass it on. Next, we have the Pure Bare It All Foundation in Blushed Medium. This was another foundation I was super excited for when it launched. It's very reminiscent of the Kat Von D Lock It to me. It does have some really nice coverage, but it is so incredibly thick. I struggled with it. I was never crazy about it. The shade selection I find a little bit lacking, and for all those reasons, I'm going to be passing it on. Next, we have probably my newest foundation. It's the Antonym Skin Esteem. It's an organic foundation. The shade is Beige Medium Light. This was sent to me PR along with some other Antonym products, although I had had this on my loves list at Sephora for quite some time. So I thought the shade match would be better for me with beige in the name. Unfortunately, it wasn't. It runs very, very yellow. I need something more pink. I know this has ingredients in it that's better for your skin, but I just don't have time to mess with foundations that aren't working for me. So for that reason, and the color, that was a huge one too, I'm going to be decluttering it. Next, we have the LA Girl Pro Coverage HD Illuminating Foundation. I have the shade Porcelain. Again, shade selection not ideal for me. I find that it runs very warm. I just feel like it doesn't really have that great of coverage, doesn't look incredibly natural on the skin. I wasn't wowed. I don't think it's awful. If you want to pick it up and try it, go for it. It's very affordable, but it just wasn't perfect for me. So yeah, declutter. Next, we have the LA Girl Pro BB Cream in the shade Light. I picked it up at the same time I bought that foundation. Full disclosure, I haven't given this one like a full-on test, shot, whatever you want to call it. I think I've worn it like 2 times. Neither time was I incredibly impressed. I just didn't really ever have a desire to really pull for it, and so I haven't, and so I'm just going to get rid of it. Next, we have the Essence Camouflage 2-in-1 Makeup in the shade 10 Ivory Beige. This was actually sent to me by my friend Vida, who lives in Lithuania, and the thing is, I actually like it. It is a damn good foundation. I think it looks really nice on the skin, provides good coverage. I don't know that I would call it high coverage, but it has good coverage without looking too mask-like. I would agree with that. The thing is, the shade is not ideal for me. It's too light for one and a little bit too yellow. So unfortunately, I'm going to be decluttering this, but I do actually like the formula if you happen to come across it. I like it. All right, let's move on to this piece of garbage Physicians Formula decided to release. This is a limited edition foundation. It makes no sense to me. The Le Velvet Foundation in the shade Ivory. The shade selection was also garbage, which is not new news at all for Physicians Formula. So needless to say, this is a declutter too. I may chunk this in the trash. I don't know. I may give it to someone if they want to try to work with it, but like, I don't even want to do this to one of my friends. And what we are left with are my 3 favorite foundations. My most favorite right now, I would have to say, is the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage. So I have the shade 020 Rose Beige. I've been wearing this daily. This bottle is probably about half gone. I will probably immediately repurchase it when it runs out. So that is a definite keeper. Next, we have the e.l.f. Acne Fighting Foundations. I do have 2 shades, my winter and my summer shade, because I love it that much. My winter shade is Porcelain. My summer shade is Beige. Beautiful coverage, looks great on the skin. So both of these are definite keepers. And that brings us to the last foundation, which is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus. So my perfect shades are Peach Natural and Rose Ivory. Peach Natural matches me when I'm at my absolute darkest, like summer vacation in Maui darkest. Rose Ivory is still a hint too light for me, even at my lightest in the winter. But these are both like perfect, super pink, cool tone shades that I just mix and match all year long to get my perfect shade, whatever it may be. Now, I do have a bottle of the Photo Focus in Classic Beige. I purchased this because I couldn't find Peach Natural one day. It was like sold out everywhere I went. So I'm going to go ahead and declutter Classic Beige and just keep Peach Natural since it matches me better. I believe I started with 14 foundations. I am keeping 5 total, essentially just 3. It's just a couple of them I have multiple shades of, and I am decluttering 9. So I consider that pretty damn successful. Let's go ahead and move on to powders. This one should be very simple because, as you can see, I only have 4. So if you know me, if you watch my channel, you know that I adore the Soap and Glory One Heck of a Blot Mattifying Powder. I think it's amazing. And as you can see, I've used up a pretty damn good bit of it. I am going to keep it and I'm going to finish it up. And if I don't like the Glossier Wowder, which is my next powder I'm going through, I will absolutely get rid of that one and repurchase this one. So this is the Glossier Wowder in the shade Light Medium. I have used it quite a few times and I do really like it. I think it's beautiful. I do like the One Heck of a Blot better, but I am going to hold on to it and I am going to use it. This is the Graftobian Luxe Cashmere HD Setting Powder in the shade French Silk. So this is my only under eye setting powder, my only baking powder. I'm keeping it. I really like it. I would like to try their translucent, like their pure translucent powder as well. And this is the only powder foundation that I own. It's the Antonym Baked Powder Foundation in the shade Light. Unfortunately for me, it is truly neutral. It's neither incredibly warm nor incredibly cool. So if you have neutral skin, you know, maybe want to check it out or whatever. But it's not a great shade match for me. It's obvious that it just doesn't work quite right because it actually does give some great coverage. So therefore, it's obvious it's not my shade. So as much as it bumps me out, and I think it's beautiful, I think it's a good product, I believe in the brand, I love the packaging, it's just not something I'm going to use because it doesn't quite fit me. So it is going to be decluttered. So that one was pretty simple and straightforward, keeping two face powders, one under eye powder, and decluttering one powder foundation. Real quick, just wanted to address these two products. It's my setting spray slash priming spray category. So now I just have these two, the Urban Decay All Nighter setting spray, which I really like, old packaging, obviously, and then the Saturday Skin Daily Dew Hydrating Facial Mist, which I use as a primer spray. So both of these are staying. Just wanted to mention them real quick. Let's finish up with primers and concealers. I just combined them because in my makeup collection, they live in the same drawer. This one's going to be more difficult. It is, but I do know of a few things I'm getting rid of. So normally I would never have this many primers. This is the only one I had until the last VIB sale, and I picked up these two minis and the Becca. So this is absolutely too many for me, but I'm keeping them. They're brand new and I'm still in the process of testing them out. This is the new-ish Becca Velvet Blurring Primer. I swatched it in store and I fell in love with it, and so I ordered it when the sale came around. Now I know a lot of people don't like it, but so far I'm really enjoying it, so I'm keeping it. This is the 100% Pure Mattifying Primer. I love this primer. I have used a good bit of it, but I feel like it lasts forever. It's not mattifying in the sense like what we expect from a mattifying primer. It just feels like a good basic primer. It also has a silicone-esque feel to it, but it is silicone-free. So if that's something you're looking for, you may want to check it out. Then I did recently pick up these two little gimmicks just to try them out. You know, there's so much hype. I wanted to try them. The mini of the Fursali Unicorn Essence and a mini of the Milk Makeup Blur Stick. Let's do eye primers because this one's gonna be a bitch. So I do have two, the NARS Pro Prime, which is awesome, and I hate that I can no longer purchase it, and then the Essence I Love Color Eyeshadow Base, which is also awesome. So the deal with the NARS eye primer is that I was super, super low on it, and I popped the stopper out of it to get the last little bit. Well, turns out there was more than just a little bit in there after I popped the stopper out, so I haven't been able to use it up yet, but it's past the point that I can give it to someone. Like, I am scraping the sides. There can't be more than just a few weeks more of use left in it. It just seems gross to give it to someone at this point. Like I said, there's barely anything left in it. I really want to use it up, and I don't think it's going to take me much longer, and so I'm going to keep it, even though I hate the fact that, like, I wanted to use it up. I wanted it to be gone by the end of the year. I wanted all of the non-cruelty-free products out of my life, but I don't want to waste it. You know, there's a little bit left in it. I don't feel right giving it to someone because it's just disgusting at this point, but I don't feel right just trashing the little bit that remains in it. So I'm going to use it up, and hopefully it'll be gone here in just a couple of weeks. And then at that point, I can move on to the Essence I Love Color, which again, I've tried a few times and really enjoyed, and it's cheap and a good, you know, cruelty-free eyeshadow base. So I'm keeping that one as my backup. Let's go ahead and move on to these last four products, my four concealers. I just used up two concealers like in the last month, and so I did have more than this. I'm kind of proud of myself for getting it down. And in all honesty, it's just being split in half. I'm getting rid of the two NARS ones and keeping the other two. So these are two pots of the NARS Soft Matte Complete Concealer, and I had tried to use them up by the end of the year, but it wasn't possible. I have the shade Vanilla, which is my winter color, and Creme Brulee, which is my summer color. As you can see, I hit pan on both of them. I used up a significant amount. When they came out, I fell in love with them, but also kind of fell out of love with them too. So I'm kind of bummed that I didn't get to use them up. It is what it is though. Someone I know who has a very similar skin tone and undertone to me can use them up. And these final two I am keeping. I have the Tarte Shape Tape in the shade Light, and then the Essence Camouflage Concealer in the shade Ivory. So I have a light coverage option and then a more full coverage option for whichever direction I want to take it, and also a drugstore and a high-end. So both of these are staying. So not the best category ever, but that eye primer will be gone here soon. And it's my fault for trying out so many primers at once. I just know now that I don't need to buy any more and I need to focus on using these up. So my declutter bin is starting to fill up. That is a ton of foundation in there. I'm gonna have to find people to split them up between because no one's gonna be able to use up that much foundation. So I hope that y'all will subscribe and stay tuned for more declutters. I pretty much have them coming up one right after the other. That's all I'm filming right now. But again, thank y'all so much for watching. I'll see you in a couple of days in my next video. Love y'all. Bye.